Dear students of standard 10, hope you are fine by the grace of Allah. Welcome back to my class. Today I will discuss chapter 9, lecture 3. Today's topic is the roles of the United Nations on the elimination of all forms of discrimination against women. You know that the United Nations from its inception enacted different international charters and rules for eliminating discrimination towards women and for preservation of their rights, such as the Universal Declaration of Human Rights in 1948. Besides, the United Nations conduct a number of functions for women development, and that are as follows. That is, I will discuss in 1949, charter was introduced, that is to confer approval of the United Nations for quelling human trafficking. In 1951, another charter was established, that is to pay the same amount of wages for the same sorts of labor to either a male or a female worker or labor by the International Labor Organization, in short, that is ILO. In 1952, to enhance women's political rights in order to cast votes and to contest with the same. In 1957, to introduce the right to preserve nationality or to change the same for the married woman. In 1960, to draw up charters eliminating discrimination in women's employment and their trading arena. In 1962, to draw up chartered declaring minimum age for women's marriage and registration. In 1962, another charter was introduced, that was equal rights in respect of education for women and girls. In 1975, the Declaration of Women's Day, it was introduced or declared in the United Nations. 1975, the first World Women Conference, that was held in Mexico. In 1976 to 1985, that is, there are 10 years, between 10 years, the Women's Decade declared. In 1979, Convention on the Elimination of All Forms of Discrimination Against Women, that is, it is called CEDAW Charter, and it was effected since 1981. In 1980, the second World Women Conference held in Copenhagen. In 1985, the third World Women Conference held in Nairobi. In 1992, the recognition of the women's right on preservation and management of the environment and development conference at Rio de Janeiro. In 1993, the recognition of the women's right as human right at Vienna conference in Austria. In 1995, the fourth World Women Conference held in Beijing. And according to this charter, the declaration of the World Women's Conference was substantiated as See the World with Women's Eyes, a platform for action, or Beijing modus operandi was adopted. In 2000, Beijing Plus 5 Conference. In 2005, Beijing Plus 10 Conference held at New York. So, therefore, we observe that the United Nations has been playing leading roles by holding different international protocols, seminars, and modus operandi for welfare of the women. Dear students, you have to memorize all these years for your short question MCQ. Now, Convention on the Elimination of All Forms of Discrimination Against Women, that means CEDAW Charter. The Charter on Elimination of All Forms of Discrimination Against Women, known as the CEDAW Charter. It was adopted on 18 December 1979 by the United Nations General Assembly and came into effect on September 3 in 1981 with the support of 20 countries. countries, including Bangladesh, ratified this charter so far. A special feature of this charter is that it is a complete charter on the rights of women, which comprises of different issues adopted at different times in order to eliminate discrimination against women. Now, the roles of CEDAW Charter against the discrimination towards women. The charter that was adopted by the CEDAW on the basis of equality without discrimination of any kind as to race, sex, creed, etc. These issues on the equal rights of the women were raised there too, since these rights had been legally mandated. Ratifying countries are bound to comply with this charter. In this charter, it was admitted that though legal rights for women were enforced in different countries, the discrimination existed over there, and it was done through foiling their access into economic or social development. This charter ensured the state's responsibility towards its women contained 30 articles, and out of 30 articles, first 16 articles describing all sorts of discrimination that existed against the women, and the rest of 14 articles explain how to eliminate such discrimination against them. On November 17, 1999, the United Nations General Assembly, in order to resist tortures on women, and declared 25 November as International Women Torture Resistance Day. Thus, from 25 November, 10 December is observed as Women Torture Resistance Fortnight across the globe. That is, there are from 25 November to 10 December, this 15 days. The United Nations has declared 8 March as the World Women's Day. And therefore, we observe that the United Nations from the very beginning has been doing a lot for women's development and making women's position much uplifted. Dear students, you have to memorize the contribution of the CEDAW Charter on discrimination, elimination of discrimination against women. Okay. So, up to this, everyone, thank you. Stay at your home safely. Goodbye.